The first event in the day four finals, day five finals and semi-finals program, session four of finals and semi-finals. We start with the men's 100 freestyle. Cesar Cielo is the world record holder at 46.91 back in the Rome World Championships in 2009. Caleb Dressel is one of the favourites. He's going to be swimming in lane number four in the first of these two semi-finals. This is how they line up. And keep your eyes on the man making the news from lane six, David Popovici, a Romanian 16-year-old, world number one, in the fastest time in the world coming into these championships. And I wonder what's going through the mind of these sprinters now.
Well, they'll all have different ways that they approach. Some will listen to music, some will just quietly reflect. What they do is try and get as much oxygenation into their lungs as they can. They do limit the way they breathe in the 100 freestyle. This is Jacob Whittle in lane number eight from Great Britain. He swam in the 4x100 freestyle relay heat team.
Swimming in one for Canada, Josh Liendo. Silver in the World Juniors, he's 18 years of age now and stepping up in competition and stepping up a level.
Maxime Grousset is in lane number seven. He is originally from New Caledonia, born there, lives in Paris, moved there at 16 years of age, comes in world rank number five.
He's not even listening to the music in his headphones. Yuri Kissel for Canada, the second Canadian into this semi-final, is swimming in lane two next to his teammate Liendo.
Well, here he is, he's 16 years of age. The world is talking about David Popovici. He is fast, he's world ranked at the top of the charts coming into Tokyo.
In three, it's Hwang Sun-woo for Korea, seventh in the 200 freestyle final. He's the world junior record holder in this 200.
Here is Alessandro Moresi from Italy. He's 22 years of age. He's the Italian record holder. He's already won an Olympic medal here in the 4x100 freestyle relay.
The big man on campus, Caleb Dressel, gold in the 4x1 freestyle relay. He's not the world record holder in this event. He was sixth in Rio, but he's a double world champion between Rio and here. All eyes on how many medals or golds Dressel might win this week. He's been the dominant sprinter in the world over the last 4 years. 24-year-old American in lane four. And that's Popovici. What an opportunity in front of this man. Fourth in the 200 freestyle, now coming down to his preferred event, the 100.
Dressel last to enter the arena. The field of play takes his time to come onto the deck. He's already checked the ledge, the kicker on the back of these red blocks. Enables the track start. It's preference for each of these athletes where that sits. There's five different settings. Whether they want a long stance or a shorter one on that track start.
The drama will unfold. It's the men's 100 freestyle first semi-final. Dressel quick off the blocks as he always is, great in flight, and he's already imposing himself on the early stages of this heat.
A good reaction time, but it's not all about the reaction time, it's what you do when you hit the water. He is very good underwater, just breathing every two, very rhythmical, throwing the arms over, not really thinking about having a bent arm. One is very straight, one is very circular. And now at the 50 metre mark, he goes out in 22.55, not that fast.
Remember, it's not about the times, is it, in Tokyo 2020? It's all about the racing, and the master racer is the American Caleb Dressel. He's being pressed by Alessandro Moresi, the Italian from lane number five, and Popovici in six is going to have to come back on the field if he wants to make it through to the final. Caleb Dressel is going to win this semi-final. The American touches in 47.23 and looking pretty comfortable in the final 5 metres, barely breathing, Caleb Dressel, and a statement from the American, 47.23 against 47.52 for Muresi.
So he sets the fastest time in the world this year, 47.23. He came in holding that at 47.26. So came back very nicely in the second 50 metres. But Muresi had a good second 50. He's also gone 47 point. In fact, four swimmers have gone 47 point. There's the differing styles. Dressel does the arms out wide, comes around to streamline position. And you saw Muresi just throw the arms forward. Here's Dressel onto the turn. Muresi is the closer one to you, and that's Popovici. Where did he finish? So he's finished in fourth, Popovici. There he is touching the wall closest to you. 47.72, and a pretty relaxed touch into the wall as well for Dressel.
Yeah, Dressel easing into this. Popovici, we need to give him a little bit of leeway, because coming in on a 47.3 from the European Juniors earlier this year, and getting anywhere near that in an Olympic Games is a huge achievement, especially when you're competing against the likes of Caleb Dressel. The experience, the strength of the American is daunting when you have to stand next to him and compete against him.
We'll see whether or not Popovici goes through. He should go through, but it'll be tight.
Dressel leads the way, 47.2, with Muresi 47.5. Now Jacob Whittle, the youngest man on the British team, with a creditable 48.11 in that first semi-final. 47.7 then. Fourth place in the first semi. Is that going to be enough to see the young 16-year-old remaining in the final? This is how they line up for the second semi-final in the men's 100 metres breaststroke. 47s are the target across the field, as we see Thomas Ceccon, the Italian, in pole position. Swimming in lane 8 then, Roman Michikov. Eighth of the Europeans for the Swiss swimmer.
Andrei Barna is in lane number 1, representing Serbia. He swam the heats of the 4x100 freestyle relay. They finished 10th.
Swimming in lane 7 for the United States, this is Zach Appel, winner of the World University Games. He's had 3 golds at the World Championships, all in the relays.
Was coached by Brett Hawke at Auburn, and then moved across to a new program. Oh, this is Nemeth in lane number 2. He's racing for Hungary in the semi-final of the 200 freestyle, final of World Championships.
And 6 for the Russian Olympic Committee. This is Andrei Minnikov, European silver medal winner. He's also a silver medal winner in the Europeans in the 100 fly.
Kolesnikov has already won an Olympic medal in Tokyo 2020. He finished 2nd, a very close 2nd in the 100 metres backstroke. He's the Russian record holder in this 100 freestyle.
In 5 for Australia, Kyle Chalmers, the defending champion, world silver medal winner. Bronze on the 4x1 freestyle team, but splitting a 46.4.
Thomas Ceccon was the fastest qualifier through from the heats. He takes lane 4. He swims backstroke as well. World rank number 7 coming into these Olympic Games. Fastest through the heats.
Ceccon in the 100 backstroke at these Olympic Games, finishing 4th. And now here he is in the 100 freestyle. What a versatile swimmer Ceccon is. Well, Kyle Chalmers, can the defending champion show us something of the quality that he displayed in Rio? And what about Kolesnikov then, the European champion, the Russian rocket, silver in the 100 backstroke in Tokyo? Keep your eyes on 3, because Kolesnikov has taken off his white hat for the traditional cap for the Russian Olympic swimmers here, and he's got his traditional pink cap so we can all see him. The second semi-final of the men's 100 freestyle. Very little between them on the reactions and on the flight, and perhaps just closer to us is Minnikov from the Russian Olympic Committee in six.
Well, it looks as though Kyle Chalmers has done his signature. Just a little slower start than the rest of the field. Chekhon also not off to a fast start. They'll come through in the second 50 metres. But Minnikov came around very fast. So too Kolesnikov. 22.52. Good splitting.
Right, the Russians are on the charge here. Firing on all cylinders and buoyed by the silver medal he won in the 100 backstroke. Kolesnikov is pulling away from the field, and watch the clock here. This is going to be a very damaging result for the rest of the field as Kolesnikov comes in 5 metres to go, and he's half a body length clear. Everybody else in a line behind the Russian. 47.11. The world record is only at 46.91, and that's going to be under threat. Kolesnikov with a statement to make against Dressel.
Faster than the winning time of Rio to win the gold medal by Kyle Chalmers. He went 47.58 to win the gold medal, 47.11. Chalmers gets into second, and it was a very close battle on the wall, not much separating them at all, and they needed to be able to be in the top part of finishing in this 100 metres freestyle to ensure a position into the final. The rest of those 47 second times in this second semi-final were actually a fair bit slower. So it's going to be interesting to see who qualifies through. Look how tight it was. Not for the winner.
Now
look
watch
how
this
far
finish.
In front. Nice straight arm by Chalmers. Got him onto the wall into second in this semi. It was needed.
The results confirmed, and the time that is going to echo around the world in the 100 freestyle is this from Kolesnikov, 47.11. Well, let's see what it all means, because we've got an almighty battle between Dressel, Kolesnikov, Miresi, perhaps Popovici. But Dressel will relish the challenge, and Kolesnikov will think, well, bring it on.